Jeepers, creepers. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I've got this to do. Things are getting crazy, folks. Remember a long time ago I told you that Pat Robertson is is not who you think he is? Pat Robertson is not a good guy, in my estimation. This guy's dangerous. Extremely dangerous. And he is leading you into the fascism of the New World Order. And some of the things he advocates are terrifying. Absolutely terrifying. This is press release number one on the website, as a matter of fact. I'm going to read it to you in just a second, just so you'll get some idea what's going on. You know, he did not write his book, New World Order. He did not write that book. And it wouldn't matter if he did. There's nothing in that book that people didn't already know. It's just a recitation of stuff that had been floating around for a little while, and none of it very serious. He doesn't identify the enemy. He doesn't even give any kind of a solution. He leaves you confused, verifying some of the things you've already been told, but leaving out all of the things that you really needed to know. And then he put his name on it. He did not write it. It was written by what's called a ghostwriter. Somebody else wrote that book for him. I doubt very seriously if Pat Robertson ever wrote it until long after it was published. But be that as it may, and if you contact his organization saying, Bill Cooper said you didn't write your book, they'll verify it for you. It's the truth. He didn't. And I've been through all this before. We made some intelligent stabs at who actually wrote it, and found out that we were wrong on who actually had written it way back at that time when I divulged the fact that Pat Robertson didn't. They will tell you who actually wrote the book. So, that's neither here nor there. You've got to hear what I'm going to tell you right now, because it's just incredible. And if you agree with him, then you're just as dangerous as he is. You see, Pat Robertson would take us back to the Dark Ages. He would take us back to the time when you could be stoned for something you said, or burned at the stake, or tortured by somebody like the Spanish Inquisition. You've got to hear this. This was this comes from the Freedom Writer magazine. Freedom Writer magazine. Now, I'm not telling you this is a good magazine or you should rush out and subscribe to it, because I don't know anything about this magazine other than this story is true. Because I happen to know people who called me when Pat Robertson made these comments and told me about it. I wasn't watching myself. So I know that he really made these statements. And we called and talked to some people at his organization. And they have confirmed that he made these statements. So here it is. And this is from Freedom Writer magazine. Remember, this is not an endorsement of the magazine. We don't know anything about the magazine, except that this one story that they printed is true. Robertson advocates stoning for UFO enthusiasts, Great Barrington, Massachusetts. In a recent pronouncement, television evangelist and head of the Christian Coalition, Pat Robertson, advocated death by stoning for UFO enthusiasts. Freedom Writer magazine, in its July-August issue, mailed today, disclosed Robertson's statement. Freedom Writer is published by the Institute of First Amendment Studies, a group that monitors the right. They consider Robertson to be the right. Anybody who advocates control is actually on the left, ladies and gentlemen, as you've learned on this broadcast. Robertson used the news of the July 4th Mars landing to promote his extreme beliefs. A segment on the July 8, 1997 broadcast of the 700 Club featured news of the Mars Pathfinder mission. Employing the historical event as a starting point, the program delved into the possibility of the existence of UFOs and space aliens. While Robertson viewed the space program with suspicion, on a more serious note, he launched into a diatribe against those who entertain the existence of space aliens and UFOs. He said in a rambling discourse that if such things exist, they are simply demons trying to lead people away from Christ. According to Robertson, the threat is so serious that people who believe in space aliens should be put to death by stoning, according to God's word. The Bible says the earth belongs to man, but the heavens belong to the Lord, Robertson says. He has given us the earth. He also warned way back when Moses was writing down not only what is the Ten Commandments, but Deuteronomy, which is almost the second law. Here is what he said to the children of Israel about this whole matter. If there is found among you within any of your gates, which the Lord your God gives you, a man or a woman who has been wicked in the sight of the Lord your God in transgressing his covenant, who has gone and served other gods and worshipped them, either the sun or moon or any of the hosts of heaven, which I have not commanded you, and you hear of it, then you shall inquire diligently. And if it is indeed true and certain that such an abomination has been committed in Israel, then you shall bring out to your gates that man or woman who has committed that wicked thing, and stone to death that man or woman with stones. Deuteronomy 17, verses 2 through 5, New King James Version. Now, that's what Moses said to the children of Israel about those who worship the sun and the moon and the hosts of heaven, because these things, at best, are lifeless nothings. Or, if they are intelligent, they're demonic. And yes, there is a host of heaven, there are angels, and there are fallen angels, there is no question about it. All of these folks are quotes directly out of the mouth of Pat Robertson. Direct verbatim quotes. He goes on, can a demon appear as a slanty-eyed, funny-looking creature? Of course he can, or it can. Of course they can deceive people. And if they can lead somebody away from the true God or away from Jesus Christ, any way it happens, it doesn't matter. You will lose your salvation. It doesn't matter how they get you. The question is, did they get you and under what guise? This is man in rebellion against God who refuses to take God's law, and God says, my covenant says you won't do this, and if I find anybody in Israel, which is his pure nation, if I find anybody in Israel that's doing this sort of thing, then I want you to take him out and dispose of him. It's a clear violation of God's word. Now, oh, boy. Let me get a drink of water, and then I'll continue. My throat is very dry. It's been dry since Nevada. Skip Porteous, Freedom Writer Publisher, commented, as the founder and chairman of the Christian Coalition, a group dedicated to becoming the most powerful political force in America, Robertson's extreme ideas need to be taken seriously, for they not only negate pluralism, but condemn to death those who dare to believe differently. How about that, folks? How about that? Now, this is incredible that he actually believes that people who are interested in solving the mystery of UFOs, and yes, Pat Robertson, there really are UFOs, for anything that you see in the sky which you cannot identify is an unidentified flying object by definition and is a UFO. Many people are trying to solve the mystery of UFOs. Are they something to worry about? Are they nothing? Is it natural phenomena? Are they top secret technology that is being operated by some earthly government, and I've already proven that that's true, at least for some of them. And are they demonic, as he says? Are they extraterrestrial from some other planet? And on and on and on and on. Because somebody is investigating this mystery does not translate to worshiping them as gods. Now, I have to tell you that I know of some way out Looney Tune woo-woo group religious organizations that really do worship them as gods and claim that they're the Nephilim of the book of Genesis and that they are the angels that were cast out of heaven to this earth and all kinds of different things going. But these are very, very small groups and for the most part are harmless, crazy people, if you want to know the truth about the men. And most of the people who are interested in so-called UFOs are just normal people who want to solve a mystery. Many of us believe that it must be solved and exposed simply because of the danger of being able to manipulate the population through deception with these things. And Pat Robertson may have already fallen into it by calling them demons. He doesn't know what they are. I mean, he's just coming off the top of his head, stating that UFOs are demons, and anybody who's interested in UFOs are worshiping other gods and must be stoned to death. Pat Robertson, you are a dangerous, dangerous, bad person. And unfortunately, there's an awful lot of people who listen to you and believe you and follow you, and you have just put them on a bad road. And stoning them to death, this is incredible. You know, I'm almost beyond words when I hear about something like this. It amazes me how absolutely stupid the human race still is after all these thousands of years and all this technology and the ability to be able to read and learn and research and investigate and find out what the truth is. We still have unbelievable bullshit artists running around steering people in paths that can only lead to destruction. And not only themselves, but other people. I mean, what if these people came to power and actually started stoning people who believe that there's something important about UFOs that we need to find out about? I might be one of the ones that get stoned because I happen to know that they're real. I happen to know that at least the ones I've investigated belong to the United States government. They're technology. Pat Robertson, they're not demons. Unless you think the people who developed them and fly them are demons. And if that's the case, then the whole human race is demons, and that might be closer to the truth than anything we've ever heard. Oh, boy. And what would you do with somebody like Stanton Friedman, who doesn't believe they're gods, you know? He's one of the manipulators. Stanton T. Friedman wants you to believe that UFOs are real so that you'll think that there's an external threat to this Earth so that we can have a one-world government. For, after all, who speaks for planet Earth? Eager Arizona? I don't think so. People in Los Angeles might not like that. Not to mention Great Britain. Argentina? Oh, no, I think you better watch out because South Africa, you know, wouldn't want Argentina speaking for them and making treaties with space aliens. So we have a world government. Don't you guys understand what all this is really all about? Demons. Demons. Here's a man on television who's watched and listened to and believed by millions of people every day, spouting the most pure, nonsensical babble I've ever heard in my life, and advocates, coming from a point of total ignorance because he doesn't know anything about the subject whatsoever, stoning to death of UFO enthusiasts. Now, I don't know what kind of definition he gives to enthusiasts. I don't know any UFO enthusiasts. I know a lot of people who are interested in investigating UFOs and discovering what the truth of UFOs are. And, you know, if you just take the most benign intention that he could possibly have, ladies and gentlemen, let me give you the results of a recent poll. Let me tell you how many people Pat Robertson is sentencing to death by stoning. 51% of the American population believe that UFOs are real and think that it's somewhat likely or very likely that federal officials were directly responsible for the U.S. Air Force withholding proof of intelligent life from places other than Earth. 51% of the population. Now, wait a minute. Let me see. Did I read that right? I'm sorry. Let me correct myself. I was off by 3 points. I'm sorry, though. We have a reputation for accuracy here. I was reading the first sentence of one paragraph and then the rest of the second paragraph. It's 48% of Americans believe that the United States government is lying about the club. How about that? Oh, this is amazing. I just can't believe he really said that. I just cannot believe that a man who is a leadership position could be so absolutely asinine. I mean, he just pulled down his pants and mooned you all right there. It's unbelievable. It's beyond my capability of understanding, ladies and gentlemen, how we seem to get smarter and dumber all at the same time. Well, it just goes to prove the old saying, there's nothing new under the sun, and probably never will be. I wrote in my book many years ago when I wrote it. It took me many years to write it, ladies and gentlemen. And then it was published in the last months of 1990. It wasn't supposed to be published until 1991, so it had a copyright date of 1991, but it actually came out, I believe, in December of 1990. But it doesn't matter. It's been published and out there for many years. 7 years, as a matter of fact. And in that book, I said that cigarette smokers were being slowly and systematically murdered because the tobacco companies were taking the tailings from uranium mines, which is highly radioactive and emits radiation at a low level, which actually warms the soil to produce a better crop of tobacco. And this low-level radiation, of course, is getting into the tobacco leaves, and people are smoking this stuff. And it's killing them through lung cancer. Low-level radiation, folks, is in many ways deadlier than a quick high dose of a lot of radiation. And kills you just as surely as a bullet will over a period of years. And people again said I was crazy. You know, in my book, I disclosed all the things that are coming out now and have been coming out for years. I disclosed the fact that they were testing biological warfare on the American people by releasing random mists of bacteria in certain places to test how many people became infected and how far it would spread through the normal contact that these people made in their ordinary everyday life. I also disclosed the radiation testing on people by the Atomic Energy Commission. I disclosed the testing of chemical agents on the American people. I disclosed the unlawful surgery that was being done on many people simply to try and reduce the level of population, and also in mind control experiments when they would put implants into the brain or perform prefrontal lobotomies without people even knowing that it was being done. And it can be done very easily just by inserting the tools up through your nasal cavity and poking through the very thin membrane into the brain to the frontal lobe and just severing the connections there. And so you get a prefrontal lobotomy by going to the doctor for an hour and not even knowing that it was done. They did this for many years. And many other things I disclosed in my book besides this. Now, folks, all of you who said that I was crazy, once again, I want you to take and write down Bill Cooper is crazy on a piece of paper, because you're going to have to eat your words. I want you to wad it up, stick it in your mouth, and start eating so that you can get it over with just as quickly as possible. And if there's nobody sitting around, you won't be too overly embarrassed. But nevertheless, you will now eat your words. Just as you've been eating your words for these last 7 years on everything that I said in my book, is all come true, folks, including the predictions for the future have come true. In my book, I predicted the first terrorist attack in the United States would be in New York City, followed by many more. And there's more to come, I got to tell you. I don't have anything to do with it. I just know the socialist agenda. I know how they operate. I know what they've done in the past. I know how they come to power. I know how they lie to you and manipulate you and fool you. I know how they're going to get your guns out of your hands, and I've been telling you for years. You don't want to believe it? That's fine. Read my book, and as all of these things come true, you can just write it down on a piece of paper. Bill Cooper's crazy, and then you can put it in your mouth and eat it. Rude? Bet your boots it's rude. So were you when you told me I was crazy. And I'm going to get ruder. You know what? Because I'm just so sick of all this namby-pamby crap that's going on and how everybody, can't we all just get along? Makes me sick. And all this stuff about Princess Diana. Oh, this is, this is beyond comprehension. Here is a woman who gave her entire life to poverty, misery, disease, starvation for long periods of time. She didn't even have a place to live. I'm talking about Mother Teresa just died. She got 3 minutes on the news. Diana is getting days and days and days, and she's going to get weeks and weeks and weeks more. You know the difference between Mother Teresa and Princess Diana? It is the stupidity of the people of the world. Because it's Mother Teresa you should be concentrating on. It is Mother Teresa who deserves all of this praise and publicity. It is Mother Teresa, but you don't want to hear that because her example was to give up all of the things that you revel in that Princess Diana had that makes her such a romantic figure. Yes, folks, she did some good things for some needy people. And that should never be discounted, nor should it be belittled. And I am not talking about Princess Diana here. I'm talking about you and the news networks and the television and the newspapers. For Princess Diana is not doing all of this, and if she were alive, she would despise it, just as she despised all the attention that she got from the paparazzi and the tabloids and everybody else. You're doing her a great disservice, for she would not have liked any of it. And maybe Mother Teresa would not have liked any of it either, but it's Mother Teresa's example that should be on the television and in the newspapers and on your lips, not Princess Diana. If Princess Diana had not been a princess and did the same things, you would not hear a whisper, not even a whimper, of any of it. For there are people who die every day who have done just as much or more, I can assure you. But no one living upon the face of this earth has done what Mother Teresa has done, nor has anyone else given up what she has given up, nor have they lived a life of utter, total poverty and filth in order to help other people like Mother Teresa did. That's my two cents. And I really don't care if you like it or not. But if you don't like it, go to the webpage and write it down in the guest book or in the feedback place. Okay? Write it down. I'll read it. Here we go. Seattle. Toxic heavy metals, chemicals, and radioactive waste are being recycled as fertilizer and spread over farmers' fields nationwide. This comes from the Associated Press. It is a major press release, which is being ignored. Why? Well, because you're all interested in Princess Diana. And there is no federal law requiring that they be listed as ingredients, the Seattle Times reported. The issue came to light in the central Washington town of Quincy, population 4,000, when Mayor Patty Martin led an investigation by local farmers concerned about poor yields and sickly cattle. It's really unbelievable what's happening, but it's true, Martin told the newspaper, which published a series about the practice on Thursday and Friday. You see, they think this is something new. It's been happening since the 50s. I wrote about it in my book. It is not new. It may be one of the reasons for the extreme incidence of cancer amongst the American people that never existed back in the 1800s, early 1900s. Until now, the State Department of Agriculture sampled fertilizers only to see if they contained advertised levels of beneficial substances. But the state is currently testing a cross-section of fertilizer products to see if they threaten crops, livestock, or people, the Seattle Post-Intelligencer reported Friday. The key question is what toxics are, as it were, along for the ride in fertilizers, said Tom Fitzsimmons, director of the State Department of Ecology. Use of industrial waste as a fertilizer ingredient is a growing national phenomenon, the Times reported. Yeah, tell me all about it. When they couldn't get rid of fluoride as a waste byproduct of the manufacture of aluminum, and since it was so poison they weren't allowed to dump it anywhere, they sold it as rat poison in the stores until they were able to convince the American population that it's good for their teeth. And so now you all brush your teeth with rat poison. Now, for many years they said we were crazy, but now on your new toothpaste tubes, the new ones that have come out since July, and some of the old ones are still on the shelves, folks. The new ones came out since July, tell you quite clearly that they're poison. Poison. Don't let your children brush their teeth with more than a pea-sized amount of toothpaste, it says. And if they accidentally swallow that pea-sized amount of toothpaste, you're to rush them to the nearest poison control center. Oh, but Bill Cooper's crazy. Don't pay any attention to me, folks. I'm just crazy. You know that? So, you know, just ignore all this stuff. Go about your business. You know, brush your teeth with five times the, you know, normal amount. If you want to. I believe in freedom. And put radioactive waste material on your crops if you want to. I believe in freedom. And I'm crazy. In Gore, Oklahoma, a uranium processing plant gets rid of low-level radioactive waste by licensing it as a liquid fertilizer and spraying it over 9,000 acres of grazing land. Wake up, America. You've been had. Hello? Is anybody out there listening? Are you really the cattle that the Illuminati think you are? Are you really a nation or world of people that will not use its intelligence and thus are stakes on the table and beasts of burden by choice and consent? Is that you? Really? Well, that's true. I wish it were not true. I really do. I set out to wake up the American people, educate them, believing in my heart that all you had to do was show them the right way. Show them the facts, the sources, the documents. Give it to them. They won't stand for it. They'll make it all right. That's what I thought. That was years ago. Boy, what a fool I was. Because I was so far off base, it's not even funny, because the American people don't want to hear it. They don't want to hear it, except for a small minority of real concerned moral people. The rest are opportunists looking for an easy life with no responsibility. They don't want to hear it. Hey, one guy told me one time, he says, I don't have time for this. I'm too busy raising a family and trying to earn a living. And then he bought me another beer. Then he bought me another beer and he didn't leave the bar till after midnight. He didn't have time. No, he didn't have time. He's too busy raising a family and earning a living. Most of his living went into that bar, ladies and gentlemen. And even if you don't drink, you're doing something just as bad. You're not doing what you ought to be doing. And I don't care if you don't like to hear that either. It's the truth. Nobody has time for anything except what feels good. At Tamas, Washington, lead-laced waste from a pulp mill is hauled to farms and spread over crops destined for livestock feed. They eat it. This heavy metal gets into their body and does not ever leave it. Heavy metal stays in the body, and then you eat those steaks, that hamburger, that roast, you eat it. In Moxie City, Washington, dark powder from two Oregon steel mills is poured from rail cars into silos at Bay Zinc Company under a federal hazardous waste storage permit. Then it is emptied from the silos for use as fertilizer. You see, they fulfill the law when they take it to the federal hazardous waste storage place under the waste storage permit. Once they've done that, there's no other restrictions. Then it's emptied from the silos for use as fertilizer. The newspaper called the powder a toxic byproduct of steelmaking, but did not identify it. I don't know what it is either, folks, but I'd like to find out. When it goes into our silo, it's a hazardous waste, said Bay Zinc's president, Dick Camp. When it comes out of the silo, it's no longer regulated. The exact same material, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, this is the Ay Chihuahua. Federal and state governments encourage the recycling, which saves money for industry and conserves space in hazardous waste landfills. The substances found in recycled fertilizers include cadmium, lead, arsenic, radioactive materials, and dioxins. Dioxins are one of the most deadly chemicals on the face of this earth. All this reported by the Washington Times. The wastes come from incineration of medical and municipal wastes and from heavy industries, including mining, smelting, cement kilns, and wood products. And I'm going to tell you again, this has been going on since the 50s, is at least the part about the radioactive waste and tailings from uranium mines being spread upon crops to fertilize them. A lot of people who've died of lung cancer have died because of that. And maybe they would have died anyway by smoking. I don't think anybody's smoking tobacco anymore, folks. I think those cigarettes are so laced with chemicals and byproducts and wastes and fertilizers and insecticides and things to make you more addicted, and I think additional nicotine is added. I don't think you're smoking tobacco anymore. God knows what it is, but it's not tobacco by the time you get it and put it in your mouth and smoke it. And folks, I'm not coming down hard on smokers. My wife and I smoked a lot until the day we found out that Annie was pregnant with poo. We decided on that day we were not going to endanger the life of that little child. We didn't know if it was going to be a boy or a girl at that time. We just knew Annie was pregnant. We decided that it's okay as freedom-loving people to endanger our own lives if we wanted to, but it's not okay to endanger the person or property of any other human being on this earth. I firmly believe that. So we stopped smoking on that day and haven't touched another cigarette since. Annie smoked 3 to 4 packs a day. I smoked 1 to 2. And we stopped cold turkey on that day. I'm not telling you you have to stop. Remember, I believe in freedom. I'm just telling you the dangers. You're not smoking tobacco anymore. It's not tobacco you're smoking. It starts out as tobacco when the seed is put into the ground. But after fertilizing it and spraying it and insecticiding it and putting radioactive waste materials on there, and then adding chemicals and more nicotine and all of the things, preservatives, it's not tobacco anymore. It's not what Columbus discovered when he came to America. It's not what the Indians were smoking, folks. It's not what they smoke today. They raise their own tobacco in the reservations. I happen to know. I've seen it. For their ceremonies, they have to raise their own tobacco. Now, I'm not telling you Indians don't smoke manufactured cigarettes, because they do. And if you want to get cheaper cigarettes and not pay so much money, go to an Indian reservation to buy them. You see, I help you out, too. Oh, my goodness. Nowhere in the country has a law that says if certain levels of heavy metals are exceeded, it can't be a fertilizer. Unlike many other industrialized nations, the United States does not regulate fertilizers. That makes it virtually impossible. Oh, yes, we do. We regulate ammonium nitrate. Yes, we do. You know why? Because they've convinced you that that's what Timothy McVeigh and Terry Nichols used to blow up the Alfred P. Murrah Federal Building in Oklahoma City. And I'm telling you right now, they did no such thing. It's already been proven scientifically beyond a shadow of a doubt by the major explosive experts in this country that a 16-wheeler tractor trailer truck full of ammonium nitrate could not have done that damage to the Alfred P. Murrah Federal Building. But you can believe whatever you want, folks. And I've discovered that you will anyway. Then the guy makes the understatement of the year. He says, this is a definite problem. I am utterly... I continually am amazed by people who are supposed to have a brain, supposed to be able to use it, many of whom graduated from some of the most prestigious schools in the world, amazing. But you know what? People are slowly catching on, folks. I don't know exactly what they're catching on to, but they're catching on. Remember I told you everybody knows something's wrong, you can feel it in their gut? Well, that's true. Anywhere you go. I mean, if you see somebody who'll tell you there's nothing wrong with anything, everything is great, then you're talking to what do you call those people who are euphoric half the time and the other half the time they're way down in the dumps? Manic depressive. You're talking to a manic depressive during one of their high states. Are you talking to somebody who's fallen into a bucket of money and it's never happened to them before in their life and all of a sudden they have money coming out their ears and out their toes and out their nose and money just falling out of the sky on them because something they did something right or they invented something or whatever. And everything is perfect. The same people, folks, are what we tend to think of as sane people, all will tell you there's something wrong, seriously wrong, but they don't know exactly what it is, or who's doing it, or why, or how to cure it. And when they think they have the answer, it's usually not the answer. It's just, you know, they get spun up in some little cul-de-sac going around and around in a circle chasing their own tail, thinking that's going to make everything all right. Like when you all jumped on Charlie Duke's bandwagon. Boy, he really had you guys fooled. He had you donating millions of dollars and running around your state trying to get these 10th Amendment resolutions passed by your state legislature. A resolution that has no teeth in law cannot force anybody to do anything. It was dumb. You all wasted your energy, wasted years of effort. Some of you got your 10th Amendment resolutions passed. What did you accomplish? Nothing changed. Nothing stopped. You were all out years of effort and tons of money. Charlie Duke now has retired from the scene. Because we spilled the beans on him, and he got tired of being totally embarrassed over this issue. And in an effort to shut me up, he joined and did succeed, in fact, with Karen Scarborough and Sharon Ford in destroying the Constitution Party, which really had a chance. All that because he was exposed as a scam artist. That's exactly what he was. You see, folks, if the federal government will pay no attention to the supreme law of the land, which contains within it the 10th Amendment, which is the supreme law of the land, your puny little state legislator passing a puny little resolution that has no teeth of the law whatsoever is not going to accomplish a thing, not a single thing ever. Stupid. Nobody stopped to think about it. They thought that was the big answer. Well, all the states pass the 10th Amendment resolution. The federal government is going to do what it's supposed to do under the 10th Amendment, which is the supreme law of the land, which it is currently ignoring. If they're brave enough and bold enough to ignore the supreme law of the land, folks, they're not going to pay any attention to a resolution. You know what a resolution is? It's Johnny going to tell his mother that he is not pleased with the way she makes his bed. That's a resolution. Johnny may be luckier than the states are with the federal government. His mother might actually listen to him. But no such luck on Capitol Hill. They've made their bed, and their bed is the New World Order. And they're propelling you into it whether you wish to go or not, you're going. Until you start using that thing that's on your head, or on your shoulders, I should say, called a head, which contains, or is supposed to contain, let me put it that way, a brain, which you are supposed to use because God gave it to you for a purpose. The purpose is not to be fashionable by knowing that you have a brain, or telling people that you have a brain, or having a certificate that says you have a brain, because I don't care how many certificates you have, if you can't use it, you don't have a brain. Most people that I meet in my everyday life have never had an original thought in their entire life, and probably never will. Everything they know or say was told to them by somebody else, or they read it somewhere. Isn't that disgusting? That brain is supposed to be what separates us from the apes, the animals. Some other people may have it more correct, however, when they say it's the human thumb. Oh, folks, I know I've got you going tonight. But you deserve it. Oh, yes, you do. You deserve every single bit of it. Yes, you do, because unless you decide to stop being stupid, apathetic, and ignorant, we're never going to get out of the situation that we're in. Never, ever, not in a million years. And the more you believe these people in government, blindly, without even checking or investigating, the faster it's going to happen. You're going to become a slave in the socialist New World Order utopian state. How about that? Good night, and God bless each and every single one of you. And may God, in His infinite bucket of mercy, save this republic.
I was born to make you happy. I think you're just my style. Everywhere I go, telling everyone I know, baby, I love to see you smile.
Don't want to pay for trip to China. Don't want to sail up the Nile. Get too far from where you are, 'cause I love to see you smile.
In the summer, in the springtime, winter or fall, the only place I wanna be is where I can see you smile at me. Like a stick without a budget.
Like a watch without a dial.
For those of you living in New York City, Pat Robertson will be in Washington Square tomorrow to stone to death UFO enthusiasts. Now, in New York City, it might be tough to find rocks, so you better get out and start gathering your bucket of rocks right now. Don't forget, join Pat Robertson in Washington Square tomorrow at high noon to stone those dastardly UFO enthusiasts. We almost had him stoned when he was picked up by the benevolent space brothers.
Well, I can see you smile at me.
In a world that's full of trouble, you make it all worthwhile. What would I do if I didn't have you? Oh, I love to see you smile.
I love to see you smile. I want to share my heart.
Don't try to stone Stanton T. Friedman, folks. He'll sell you a used car or a used saucer. You're listening to the Worldwide Freedom Radio Network. Stay tuned now for all oldies most of the time. Classic radio like you always wished it could be. Only the very best of the very best music of generations gone by.
One by one, they're turning out the light. I've been feeding that old guitar just to hold you tight. Guess it's for the best. I just put in my last dime.
That's the guy, folks, who told me he didn't have the time. See you tomorrow night.
Another time.